Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Whitney Madoni and it is Valentine's Day. So happy Valentine's Day to all the lovely couples out there. All the love, guys. I love love. I am a hopeless romantic. And so, in the spirit of Valentine's Day, I thought I would share with you guys five things that you probably did not know about sex.
Yo, I don't think we should talk about this. People might misunderstand what we're trying to say, you know?
Y'all 90s babies know exactly what I'm talking about. I was maybe in the 80s. And I was raised by a lot of my younger aunties. They were young, my aunties and uncles, so they exposed me to a lot. let's just say that. So anyway, let's get right into it. Number one of the things that you probably did not know about sex. Orgasms are a natural pain reliever. Yes! So the next time you have a headache and you're feeling a little frisky, just reach out to your significant other and the headache will be gone. You'll be feeling so much better. Isn't that so cool? I love nature. God is amazing. Sex is a gift from God. I definitely believe that. What was the word? There was a little controversy about sex being the forbidden fruit, but I absolutely do not think so. I think it's an amazing thing as long as it is done between two consensual adults. And if you are a Christian like me, you do believe that sex is supposed to be between husband and wife. Yes. So,
number two,
shaving your pubes actually increases your chances of getting an STD or an STI, whatever you guys call it. Yeah, so when you shave down there, you take away like the protective barrier that is there to like, you know, keep all those bad things away. And when you shave, you just leave the area, like you see when you get ingrown hair, you leave your pores open, which allows, like, in case you were to hook up with somebody who had an STD, chances are you would get it faster when you are shaved down there. So I'm all about grooming is super important, but don't get rid of everything. It's there for a reason. Yeah, that's all I'm saying. Number three, alcohol. Alcohol is not actually good for sex. While it may lower your inhibitions and you're gonna do things that you probably wouldn't do when you were sober, it actually numbs your nerves, your sexual nerves and all that. And so you don't feel things the way you would have felt them if you were sober. So, which is also very important about why you need to hook up with somebody that you're comfortable with. Like, you don't need to be hooking up with somebody that you need to get drunk before you hook up with. That's all I'm saying. But that's just my two cents. Number four is, did you know that your nose gets bigger during sex? Yes, it is not only your sexual organs that get enlarged and engorged when you're doing the do. Your nose actually does get bigger. It is your blood actually comes and gets full around this place. So that's isn't that interesting? Very interesting. So number five, last but not least, did you know that contraceptives, birth control pills, the coil, any type of like hormone altering like substance that you put in your body, it actually affects your partner, like the type of person that you're attracted to. And let's say, for example, you get off the pill maybe to get kids, you know, when you're married to someone that you are in birth control when you first started hooking up, and then eventually you got married, and then you get off the pill later, and then you're wondering, why are things so different? Why am I not really attracted to this person the way I was attracted to them in the first place? It's because getting off that pill or being on that pill actually affects the type of person that you do attract. It affects your hormones, and you can be attracted to somebody, and then later when you're off the pill, you're just like, why is it that I can't stand this man? What is wrong? Why aren't things the same? Kumbe, it's the birth control that you're taking. So it is very, very, very important to also go and you talk to your doctor. Have a gynecologist when you're getting into that whole like birth control thing, because you never know. And also like general things, when you see that your body is changing in ways that, you know, things are happening and they weren't happening before, take note and tell your gyna, because that could be the problem. Even in your marriage, you're wondering, why is it that all of a sudden, man, when I stopped taking those pills and I got pregnant, I don't like this guy, but I love him. The problem could be your pills. I thought that was super, super, super interesting. So I hope that you enjoyed today's video. 5 things that you probably did not know about sex. And tune in for the second part of this series, because we were talking about the good things. Now I'd like to talk about the serious things about sex. So, mwah, mwah, mwah. Keep it locked. Happy Valentine's.